Parshas Ki Tse, Tovshin Pei Aleph. We're about halfway, almost halfway through Elul, about 2.5 weeks left to Rosh Hashanah. Lots of work to do. And I'd like to speak this week about an idea for the fast approaching Yomim Noroim that the Nesiv HaShalom learns about and derives from this week's Parsha. And we're going to take a lesson and something that we can take with us to Rosh Hashanah, an idea that we could use, something that we can use to grow. And that is the idea of the Koyach HaRabim. Koyach HaRabim means that we are the strength in numbers, the strength of being together with Klal Yisrael, that a person is not on their own. That we do not go to battle. As Jews, we do not go to battle on our own. There's a special koyach of doing things together. Nesiv HaShalom says, and he says a story, something that happened many years ago, that somebody came in to the Divrei Shmuel, previous from the Slonimer dynasty, many years ago. Someone came to the Divrei Shmuel on Erev Yom Kippur, right before Kol Nidre. And he comes to the Divrei Shmuel, and this person, he's very, very down. And the person kept saying that, you know, it's so tough to come, to be able to go into Yom Kippur. I feel so low. I've done so many things over this year. I haven't been able to be as good as I want to be. How is it possible for me, he asked the Divrei Shmuel, how is it possible for me to go into Yom Kippur like this? I just don't find it possible. I can't do this. So the Divrei Shmuel answered him, that, you know what, I want to tell you something. He says, I feel the same way. And of course, the Divrei Shmuel on his level, but he says, I feel inadequate. I feel like, me too, he says, I feel I did not live up to everything that I wanted to do over this year, he says, but there's a tried and true Eitzah, which I know that I can use and you can also use. And you know what that Eitzah is, said the Divrei Shmuel, that you don't go into Yom Kippur, you don't go into the Yomim Noraim, you don't go alone. You go with all the Jews together. And the Divrei Shmuel took the hand of this person, and he said, come, I'm going to hold your hand, and together we're going to walk into the shul. And that's how they walked in for Kol Nidre. And he said, now we can both have confidence. Tried and true, Eitzah, that if a person knows, I'm not doing this alone, I'm not here on my own, I'm part of a bigger unit, I'm part of a Klal Yisrael, I'm part of my friends, I'm part of my chaverim, I'm part of my learning group, I'm part of this Nesiv HaShalom Shir. Every Thursday night we go as a group. We're not individual. Tried and true Eitzah to be able to go into Yom Kippur. Either way, the message that the Divrei Shmuel and here the Nesiv HaShalom is trying to give over is that the way to be able, when it comes to the Yom HaNoraim, the way to be able to stand before Hashem is with the Koyach HaRabim. Because that's what ties us together. Ki Ish Echad, B'Lev Echad, the Klal Yisrael, the way Hashem wants to see us, not as individuals, Hashem wants to see us, B'Achdus, getting along, although so many different factions in Klal Yisrael, so many different types of people, so many different ways of serving HaKadosh Baruch Hu, different approaches, different types of people. Hashem wants to see that we understand that we're all brothers, we're all sisters, and that we all get along, and that we are ba'achdus, ki ish echad b'lev echad. That's the way we approach Hashem when it comes to the Yomim Noraim. And says in the Nesiv HaShalom that when that happens, and we're ba'achdus, the Satan does not have shalita over us. He does not have shalita over us when we are ba'achdus. And that is what we say in Shmoneh Esrei, in every single Shmoneh Esrei, Baruchenu Avinu Kulanu Ke'echad. in order to be zoicha to the be'or panecha, in order to be zoicha to the light of Hashem, in order to be zoicha to the bracha of Hashem, you know what it has to be? Kulanu ke'echad. Barchenu avinu, we're able to get the bracha only when we are b'shalom. Those words, barchenu avinu kulanu ke'echad, are in the bracha of shalom. And if we are b'shalom, and we're all getting along, then we're zoicha to the ba'or panecha. We're zoicha to bask in the great light of HaKadosh Baruch Hu on us. And barchenu avinu, we're able to get that bracha. There's a pasuk in our parsha, and the pasuk says as follows: Ki yeh becha ish, you have a person asher lo yeh tohar. He was not tohar. In other words, he was tamei. V'yotza el michutz lamachaneh. A person is tamei. He has to go chutz lamachaneh. He has to leave the place where Klal Yisrael dwelt. He had to go chutz lamachaneh. Says in Tziva Shalom a pshat on this pasuk that we can explain these words. The pasuk pshat in the pasuk is as we said. Ki yev chayish shaloye tahor. You have a person who's not tahor. V'yotza el michutz lamachaneh. He has to go out. Says in Tziva Shalom. You can explain the pasuk al pi drush like this. If you see a yid asher loy tohar, you see a yid who is not tohar, in other words, that he's not connected now to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it is a simon that he stepped michutz lamachaneh. Because as we said, if we are together with the machaneh, if Klal Yisrael is together, then the satan has no shlita over us. If you see a person asher lo yeh tohar, it must be v'yotza el michutz lamachaneh, that he stepped away and he was not part of Klal Yisrael. He wandered away from the group. He wandered away from his brethren, the people of Klal Yisrael. He was not nevatel himself to the tzibur. Very, very insightful, very interesting pshat on that pasuk. And as we have said over, we've spoken about this many times, the incredible thing that the Saba Kedisha Milechevich, Tzichusi Yogan Aleinu, says, and this is something that every person really has to listen to, and every person really has to hear, and every person has to internalize. Says the Saba Kedisha like this, you know, and this only very, very people that lived in a different plane, lived in a different world, could actually know these things and say these things. But he says, you know something, when min hashamayim, they wanted to, let's say chas v'shalom, they want to do something negative to a person, min hashamayim. If they want to do something negative to a person, min hashamayim, they start putting tainus and problems with the leaders and the rabbonim in this person's head. They start putting things in this person's head. He shouldn't be happy with his leaders, shouldn't be happy with the rabbonim, and you become a person who is not a person of shalom. You become a person who is not ba'achdus. Because once again, if we're ba'achdus and we're b'shalom, the satan doesn't have shlita over us. So min ha-shamayim, if they want to do something, quote, bad or negative to a person, they start putting things in this person's head against the leaders of the generation, against rabbanim. He becomes a person of machlekes, and unfortunately we all know such people, and we all know people that thrive on these things, but that's what's happening, says in Tziva Shalom. And if they really want to punish this person, and they want to punish him more, then they start putting tainus in his head about his neighbors, and his friends, and his chabura, all those kind of people, so he really becomes a person of machlokes. He really becomes a person who is not the shalom. And once a person, once you become a ba machlokes, you start talking lashon hara, you start looking negative at other people, then you're not considered in min hashamayim, you're not considered ba'achdus, you're not considered a person of shalom, you're not considered a person of Klal Yisrael, and then chas v'shalom, they can do something negative to you. So, says the Nesiva Shalom, if you see someone who has tainus, I know, you know, people who are gripe and are not happy with anything, people who have tainus on everybody, and they're causing machlekes, just know that min hashamayim, they're trying to push this person away. They're trying to push this person away that now the Satan, that now negative influences, Min HaShamayim, can have and reach that person. It's really a very, very scary thought indeed about how careful we have to be to not be a person of negativity, to always be a person who's positive and connected, dan lekav schus, b'shalom with other people, looking for the good things in other people, because aside from all the other virtuous things that we have from that, it is also a tremendous siman that you're connected, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to do good things for you when you are that way. And of course, the lesson is really the flip side of that. That if you are a person who is a friend of peace, and you're a person who is, like we said, who is not always looking to have kindness on other people, then you are protected from negative things, min hashamayim. The pasuk says, ki seitze machaneh aloivecha. If you go out as a machaneh, if you go out the achdus, you go out as one, the pasuk continues in our parsha, v'nishmartem, he called avara. If you're a person, ki seitze machaneh aloivecha, if you go to fight the Yetzer Hara, if you go to fight other things, you go out as a machaneh, if Klal Yisrael is together, then that pasuk finishes, v'nishmarta mikol dovara, that you are taking upon yourself, before Rosh Hashanah, before Yom Kippur, the biggest protection that you can have, that Hashem wants to see, that you are a person b'shalom, you are a person of peace, you're protected. Ki Hashem elekecha mishalech, the pasuk says in our parasha also, where does HaKadosh Baruch Hu hang around? HaKadosh Baruch Hu bekerev machanecha. If you are a machaneh, if you're as one, then Hashem kaviyachol hangs around there. Within the machaneh, that is where Hashem is found. The Sivah Shalom tells us that especially during the Yom Noroim, where our biggest bakasha, our fervent bakasha is, what do we ask Hashem? We ask, Rachameinu kerachem av al banim. We're asking HaKadosh Baruch Hu, have mercy on us in the great way, right? What kind of mercy? The mercy that a father has on his children. So if we're asking Hashem for that, and now, of course, we're about, a week and a half before Slichas, you're asking Hashem so many times, Gerachem Av Al Bonim, we need to act as children, and children need to act as one family in order to have Hashem as our Av. If everybody's acting like they're in a different family, it's hard to have the same father. But if we're all part of the same group, if we all act and respect each other, and we act respectfully to each other, and we act as children of one family, then Hashem is the father, and he's the father of all of us. And that is Rachameinu Kirachem of one father, Albonim, for all of us. And the biggest koyach, says in the Sivah Shalom, the biggest koyach to take us into the Yom Noroim is that koyach harabim. You can't have koyach harabim if you're arguing with everybody, if you don't consider yourself part of the tzibur, if you don't consider yourself one of the group. To be mevatel yourself to the tzibur, to understand that there's something bigger going on over here. It's not about me and mine. It's about everybody. It's about us as a group, about us as a family, the koyach harabim, that whatever you do, be a member of this great team. Because if you're a member of this great team, and you're not a person of machloikis, you're not a person of discord, you're not a person who separates Klal Yisrael, then you have the words in this week's parsha, this machaneh. And what happens when we're part of one machaneh? Then the Torah tells us, unesonai Hashem alekecha biyadecha, which is either taka the enemies or the Yetzer Hara. Hashem gives it all, and he will give everybody over to us. And we should taka learn this lesson, and be zaycha, that we go as a group. We go to Rosh Hashanah, like the Divrei Shmuel, we go with each other, together. Nobody tries to stand alone. Nobody tries to be individual. Understand that we are all part of this one great machaneh, this one great group called Klal Yisrael.